Hello students, welcome back. Let us continue reading the fourth chapter from your Hornbill textbook. The title of the chapter is Landscape of the Soul. So we had read till page number 35, last paragraph, and today we are to begin from page number 36. Let's read. This concept is expressed as Shanshui, literally mountain water, which used together represent the word landscape. More than two elements of an image, these represent two complementary poles, reflecting the Taoist view of the universe. The mountain is yang, reaching vertically towards heaven. Stable, warm, and dry in the sun, while the water is yin, horizontal and resting on the earth, fluid, moist, and cool. The interaction of yin, the receptive, feminine aspect of universal energy, and its counterpart yang, active and masculine, is of course a fundamental notion of Taoism. What is often overlooked is an essential third element, the middle void, where the interaction takes place. This can be compared with a yogic practice of pranayama: breathe in, retain, breathe out. The suspension of breath is the void where meditation occurs. The middle void is essential. Nothing can happen without it. Hence, the importance of the white, unpainted space in Chinese landscape. So this paragraph talks about the Chinese concept of art that is also expressed as Shanshui, which also means mountain water. The literal meaning of Shanshui is mountain water, which when used together represents the word landscape. Okay, now these two elements, mountain and water, represents two complementary poles of the universe known as yang and yin. And this yang and yin, it reflects the Taoist view. Now the mountain in the landscape is yang, which reaches vertically towards heaven. It's called to be stable, warm and dry in the sun, while the water is yin, which is horizontal. This we all know, that the water is flows horizontally. So the yin, which is called horizontal, resting on the earth, it's in fluid state. It's moist and cool. It is called to be receptive and the feminine aspect of universal energy. Then about yang. Yang is considered to be active. It is considered to be masculine and of course the opposite of yin. And then comes the third essential element. Then there is a third essential element, which is known as the middle void. Now this middle void is the place where the yang and the yin interact, heaven and earth interact. So this middle void can be compared to pranayama. The writer says that this middle void that can be compared to pranayama, which means to breathe in, to retain and breathe out. So while we breathe in, we also keep our breath inside. We just stop breathing, exhaling or inhaling. We just stop that breath, that is retaining, and then we breathe out. So here the suspension, when we don't breathe or exhale, that suspension of the breath is the void, the empty space. Void means the empty space. And in this meditation process, this empty space, this void, this suspension is the main process, I mean main part of the meditation process, and it is a very integral part of this pranayama. Okay, so it is an essential part, as nothing can happen without it. Hence the white unpainted space in the Chinese landscape which we see is equally important, because in this blank space or in this white portion on the landscape, on the paintings, in these white portions only the viewer is able to use his power of imagination, and he is able to perceive the landscape, the painting, as per his own creativity. So here the viewer, in this white space, the viewer gets to imagine things as per his own creativity. So the person gets to exercise his own creativity in this white space, in the landscapes, in the Chinese paintings. Okay, further let us read. This is also where man finds a fundamental role. In that space between heaven and earth, he becomes the conduit. Conduit means the channel of communication between both poles of the universe. His presence is essential, even if it's only suggested. Far from being lost or oppressed by the lofty peaks, he is, in Francois Chang's wonderful expression, the eye of the landscape. So here it's told by the writer that the middle void is where a man finds an important role. So the man is very important over here, as man is the channel of communication in the space between heaven and earth. Again, we all have already read this, that heaven and earth, yin and yang, are the two poles of the universe. So the man is A man is the channel of communication in between heaven and earth, yin and yang. And it's said his presence is essential, so which means that man's presence is essential over here in the void, in the middle void. And man is not oppressed or lost by the lofty peaks, but he is the eye of the landscape, as said by Francois Chang. So man is the eye of the landscape. Why? Because man is the center of life, okay, and the entire creation plan, the entire creation that has been done, it is all incomplete without the presence of man. And man plays the key role in linking heaven and earth, and he is the only channel of communication between the two worlds. Moreover, as human body is incomplete without an eye or the eyes, so the entire creation, according to Francois Chang, he means to say this, that the entire creation is also incomplete without a man. Hence, he is called to be the eye of the landscape. Okay, so this was an excerpt from Landscape of the Soul, Ethics and Spirituality in Chinese Painting. And this has been slightly edited. Let us quickly go through this part, Getting Inside Outsider Art. I'll just quickly read the entire block. When French painter Jean de Buffet mooted the concept of art brut in the 1940s, the art of the untrained visionary was of minority interest. From its almost wheeled beginnings, outsider art has gradually become the fastest growing area of interest in contemporary art internationally. This genre is described as the art of those who have no right to be artists, as they have received no formal training, yet show talent and artistic insight. Their works are a stimulating contrast to a lot of mainstream offerings. Around the time de Buffet was propounding his concept in India, an untutored genius was creating paradise. Years ago, the little patch of jungle that he began clearing to make himself a garden sculpted with stone And recycled material is known to the world today as the Rock Garden at Chandigarh. Its 80-year-old creator-director Nick Chand is now hailed as India's biggest contributor to outsider art. The 50th issue, Spring 2005, of Raw Vision, a UK-based magazine pioneer in outsider art publications, features Nick Chand and his Rock Garden sculpture, Women by the Waterfall, on its anniversary issue's cover. The notion of art brut or raw art was of works that were in their raw state as regards cultural and artistic influences. Anything and everything from a tin to a sink to a broken down car could be material for a work of art, something Nick Chand has taken to dizzying heights. Recognizing his art as an outstanding testimony of the difference a single man can make when he lives his dream. The Swiss Commission for UNESCO will be honoring him by way of a European exposition of his works. The 5-month interactive show Realm of Nick Chand, beginning October, will be held at leading museums in Switzerland, Belgium, France, and Italy. The biggest reward is walking through the garden and seeing people enjoy my creation, Nick Chand says. Brinda Suri, Hindustan Times, 28 August 2005. So in this article, Getting Inside Outsider Art, it's been told that a French painter, Jean Dubuffet, he first created the concept of art brut, or which is also called or known as a raw art. He created this concept in the year 1940s. Then the art of the untrained visionary was of minority interest. Very less people were interested in this art. But gradually the outsider art became the fastest growing area of interest in international modern art. And this particular type of work is the creation of those, it's said that this outsider art is the creation of those people who have no right to be artists, as they have not received any formal trainings. Yet they have this talent and they have artistic insight to showcase their creativity. Okay, so outsider art is for those people. It is also written about Nick Chand that his art has been recognized as an outstanding testimony of the difference a single man can make when he lives. So if a man really is interested in certain kind of art, and he really puts in some efforts to achieve what he dreams of, he can surely fulfill all his dreams like Mr. Nick Chand did. Further, it's also told that the Swiss Commission for UNESCO will be honoring him by way of a 5-month interactive show of his works. And also Nick Chand, at last he says that walking through the garden and watching sculpture, people enjoy his creation, which is one of the biggest rewards for him. So this 80-year-old creator director Nick Chand, who was an untutored genius, he used anything and everything from a tin to a sink to a broken down car to form various artistic pieces and sculptures. And one of his very famous rock garden sculpture is that of a woman by the waterfall. Okay, so we would be discussing the question answers and all your doubts in the next session. So I request you all to again reread the chapter very carefully, mark the difficult words, and also jot down the doubts that you have from this chapter. Thank you, everyone.